His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sukhir Palace today Commander of the U.S. Central Command General Lloyd Austin III and his accompanying delegation on the occasion of their visit to the kingdom. His Majesty the King hailed the deep-rooted historic relations and joint coordination between the two countries and people, as well as growing bilateral cooperation and progress in all fields as allies and partners. His Majesty stressed Bahrain's keen interest to further develop relations of friendship and cooperation with the U.S. in all areas, especially in the military and defense fields. He also hailed the U.S.'s role in maintaining international peace and stability, expressing appreciation for General Austin's efforts in reinforcing cooperation with Bahrain and with the Arabian Gulf. The meeting also reviewed latest political developments in addition to ways of preserving the region's security and stability. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa chaired the weekly cabinet meeting at Ghadibia Palace today in the presence of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The cabinet discussed various items on the agenda, reaching several decisions. After the meeting, the Minister of State for Information Affairs and official government spokeswoman Samira bin Rajab held a press conference in which she outlined the cabinet session and reviewed the decisions reached.
The cabinet received a letter from His Majesty the King commending his latest visit to the People's Republic of China. His Majesty underlined the signature of a number of conventions between the two countries and lauded the efforts of Bahrain as the president of the current GCC session in deepening the GCC-Chinese relations. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister expressed his high interest in this success and his aspiration to further strengthen the relations between Bahrain and China. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister appointed His Excellency the Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Mohammed bin Barak Al Khalifa as the head of the committee concerned with following up on the implementation of all conventions signed with China during the last visit. On a separate note, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister re-emphasized his concern and gave directives to all ministries to facilitate ministerial services to all services without delay. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister also expressed his great interest in the Arab League's decision to choose Bahrain as the headquarters for the Arab Court of Human Rights and is hoping that this decision gets implemented in due course. Confronting all that's being communicated by some parties to harm Bahrain, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister stressed that civil liberties and human rights in the Kingdom of Bahrain Bahrain are protected by the Constitution, the law, institutions, and the official and national will in light of the reform and political project of the Kingdom of Bahrain. Finally, the cabinet extended its congratulations to the leadership and people of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia on the occasion of the Kingdom's National Day. The cabinet discussed during the regular session of September the 22nd, 2013 in Qudaybiyah Palace a number of subjects and memorandum listed on the agenda. The following decisions were made.
The cabinet
measures for the implementation of national indicators. The cabinet took note and discussed the memorandum presented by His Excellency the Minister of State for follow-up on the actions that have been taken regarding the national indicators. The cabinet had agreed at a previous session on creating national indicators that would enhance competitiveness in the Kingdom of Bahrain in the fields of national economy, the quality of life, lifelong learning, the knowledge economy, and the sustainability of natural resources. In this framework, the cabinet took note of the actions that took place in this regard, represented mainly in organizing the workshop for government authorities and entities. During this workshop, national indicators and the mechanisms for their implementation were put in place, and a team was formed in cooperation with the Central Informatics Organization to oversee 1. Sort and identify inputs in national indicators, 2. Issue a manual that explains the concept and mechanisms for measuring national indicators, 3. Organize workshops and training programs, 4. Establish an electronic system for storing data of national and international indicators, collecting and analyzing data of national and international indicators.
The cabinet regulations
of the legislative decree number 21 for the year 2013 on the regulation of raising money on the for the general purposes of the Ministry of Social Development. The cabinet decided to refer the memorandum to the relevant ministerial committee for further review. The cabinet took note and discussed the memorandum presented by His Excellency the Minister of Justice and Islamic Affairs on the latest preparations done by the Supreme Committee for Hajj and Umrah Affairs and the Bahraini Hajj Mission for the year 2013. The Supreme Committee for Hajj and Umrah Affairs in the Ministry of Justice and Islamic Affairs held several meetings with the heads of the Bahraini Pilgrimage Mission to review all preparations in order to ensure the success of the pilgrimage season as well as the safety of the pilgrims. Bahrain collaborated with the concerned parties in the Ministry of Hajj in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia to ensure that Bahraini pilgrims have enough spaces to perform the sacred practices of Hajj. The quota for Bahraini pilgrims for this year is estimated to be 3,700 pilgrims.
His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received at Qudaybiyah Palace today Commander of the U.S. Central Command General Lloyd Austin III and his accompanying delegation on the occasion of their visit to the kingdom. The two sides discussed the deep-rooted Bahraini-American relations, military coordination, and defensive cooperation. They also reviewed recent regional and international developments as well as issues of mutual concerns. His Royal Highness also stressed the need for concerted international efforts to eliminate the causes of tensions in many parts of the world, underscoring the importance of building an effective international partnership to achieve global peace and security. For his part, General Austin asserted his country's keen interest to expand ways of joint cooperation with Bahrain so as to meet the aspirations of both countries and people. His Royal Highness, the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received at Ghadibiya Palace today, Commander of the U.S. Central Command, General Lloyd Austin III, and his accompanying delegation on the occasion of their visit to the kingdom. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince affirmed Bahrain's keen interest to support all regional and international efforts to maintain security and stability and reinforce peace in the Middle East. He commended the growing development between Bahrain and the U.S. and the joint cooperation in all fields, specifically in the military and defense areas. The meeting reviewed issues of common concern, regional developments, and the issues of security and peace in the Middle East. For his part, General Austin lauded Bahrain's facilities to the U.S. in the region and the ongoing cooperation and coordination in all fields that serve both countries' aspirations to support security and stability. The chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sport and president of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, affirmed that His Majesty the King supports all initiatives and efforts aimed at enhancing world peace. He added that His Majesty, and during all events, calls for exerting more efforts in order to consolidate peace, living in harmony and security through adopting programs and procedures that will contribute in ending conflicts so that nations can proceed with sustainable development projects. This came during a speech delivered by His Highness Sheikh Nasser during the opening of the International Youth Conference under the slogan Youth of Peace. The event was organized by the GOYS, the GOYS, and was attended by a number of kingdom officials, diplomatic corps, and a number of youth, as well as 26 delegations that are participating in the conference. In his speech, His Highness Sheikh Nasser said that the Kingdom of Bahrain has been withholding to peace, which comes as part of its Islamic religion belief that calls for peace, forgiveness, and living in coexistence. He added that Bahrain hosting the Arab Court for Human Rights signifies that the kingdom is an oasis of peace, one that advocates its commitment and keenness for justice and peace. This is in addition to Bahrain hosting the Civilization Dialogue, which clearly indicates Bahrain's path of peace, forgiveness, and living in coexistence. Sheikh Nasser went to say that the success of the international community to support development in different parts of the world will definitely contribute in laying down a solid foundation for peace and working towards achieving that through an appropriate vision and action. He also highlighted that for the youth to participate in the peace process, there is a need for coming up with the methodologies for their participation that would give the youth an opportunity to play a real role in the peace process. He underscored the importance of government support for youth in their involvement and participation endeavors. Sheikh Nasser voiced hope such suggestions could be of benefit so that the conference can come up with recommendations that would serve the world and its future, including the making of peace in the whole world. Sheikh Nasser extended thanks and appreciation to the United Nations for its support in order to add success to the conference. He also valued the interaction of the participating countries' embassies, as well as speakers who came from different countries of the world in order to take part in the event.
البحرين على استقبالها لنا لتنظيم حفل الافتتاح على رعايتها وتغطيتها لجميع فعاليات وفي النهاية هذه هدية تذكار الخليفة رئيس المجلس الأعلى للشباب والرياضة رئيس